generation trying to do something different. We trying to grow. Our generation trying to do something different. We trying to grow mentally, spiritually, get some tangibles so that we can stop working for the dang same white man you condemn on the street, or we wherever we at condemning the white man, but we don't have a plan together to get off his job.
Get your money, man.
Very hard, and the work that we have to do is very let me tell you why it's gonna be very hard, and the work that we have to do is very hard. We got a brother in the comment section talking about we Israelites dropped the Muslim thing. To be very clear as possible, what the hell do that have to do with us discussing a plan for our people? I don't get it. What the hell do that have to do with us discussing the plan of Brother Ice Cube right now? We want to argue about Muslim and Israelite once again. That ain't changing our condition. Because the very people we be talking about, hell, sometimes our condition be way worse than theirs, but we supposed to have God and the Most High and Allah. It ain't about all that right now, man. We could talk about religion and all that, nationality and bloodline and beliefs after we free. We can talk about it, but we can talk about the differences and argue back and forth after we free, because most of us be ignorant with our arguments anyway.
All right, Shalom. I want to give all the praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai Bahasham, Rahakudash, Yahweh being the name of the Heavenly Father, the Holy One of Israel, whom the world ignorantly calls God, and Yahweh Shai being the name of his only begotten Son, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ, in the name of the Holy Spirit. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone, and peace and mercy to the house of David, the elect, the 144,000 prophets, the men of the Lord that are doing his word in sincerity and truth, and the 1/3 of the men, women, and children of the house of David, the elect. To you all, I say greetings and shalom. All right, this lesson is brought to you through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. Hopefully, it's Lord willing, it's edifying. Okay, so, you know, we have this individual whose name is Brother Ben X, you know, and I've seen different clips of this guy before. And I've seen it, you know, sometimes he has respectful situations with Israelites that I tend to see. You know, there's a couple things that you need to understand about how the world operates and in his video, he said, we need to have a plan. Okay, that's what he said. So he doesn't understand certain things about the spirit. And this is why he said the thing that he said. He thinks that under influence of man, so to speak, he can do things like establish a kingdom here. Okay, he thinks that he can follow in the footsteps of his of our forefather, you know, well, his forefather, it's our forefather, you know, Malcolm X, you know. But the thing is, Malcolm X even had parts of the truth, but he didn't understand it completely, you know. And he tried having a regular everyday plan. Malcolm X was trying to take that road, but what happened? It was destroyed once again because it wasn't through the spirit of the Lord, the true Heavenly Father. Okay, and it also, the scriptures talk about how the apostles are sent forth last. Okay, because all of the things like modern day Christianity, Islam, all of, by the way, Brother Ben X is a part of the Nation of Islam. He's a Muslim, okay, which is actually that religion belongs to the Ishmaelites or the so-called Arabs. Okay, of course, now they led it to where anybody can join. All right, but that religion is for the Ishmaelites, and you good sir are an Israelite. Okay, and but the thing is, we always want to follow after the heathen. Okay, and I'm not getting on here to necessarily bash the brother. We just believe in rebuking and exhorting, and I really want to get into what is our plan and how the plans that you think will not work. And that's why the young man said, you're an Israelite, this is not going to, whatever the effect he said, but the man was trying to tell me he's an Israelite. And Brother Ben X Salakia, excuse me, the Brother Ben X didn't quite understand the gravity that he meant when he said that. Of course, we have different Israelite groups, but the thing is, the Lord says in the last days only 1/3 of his people are going to be delivered when he returns. So 2/3 of our people are going to absolutely have no clue. Majority of our people have no clue what's going on through the spirit, and they're going to be put to death according to Zephaniah 13 and 8 through 9. Okay, but let me read this first. I have a couple of scriptures that I want to bring out, and then I'll get to the point about what's our plan. This is Hosea 4 and 6. This is one that I'm sure you've heard. All right, it says, "My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee, that thou shalt be no priest to me. Seeing that thou hast forgotten the law of thy God, I will also forget thy children." You see that? So our people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. All right. And what is that main knowledge? Of the Bible, of the scriptures, of our heritage, knowing who we are. Okay. And we're not only knowing it, but rejecting it. Okay. And so, like, you, sir, you have heard that you're an Israelite, and you know, even from Farrakhan, okay, even from Malcolm X, you have been told that you're an Israelite. But the thing is, you rejecting that knowledge. And so the Lord says he will reject you, since you have forgotten the law of thy power, he will also forget your children, and he will reject you, man. You know, and what man wants that to be happen to God, to reject you? All right. But you, y'all God is Allah, right? Which is a cobblestone, and simply means Allahayim, which means power or powers. Okay, that's not a name of a power, man. Okay, but nonetheless, this is, like I said, this is not to bash. I could go all day going on Islam and the problems with it. Okay, because we know that even in your book, and what's that, Second Surah 122, all right, it says that even the children of Israel, I preferred you over the worlds. So even in the Quran, we are stated as the chosen people, man. Okay, but nonetheless, like I said, this isn't about that. I want to mention a couple of scriptures. First, I want to state this. You have to understand the curses that are on our people to even understand our plight. Okay, so I'm going to read Deuteronomy 28 and 15. Read, if you get a chance, Brother Ben X, and I'm sure you even heard it, maybe even read it. If you read Deuteronomy 28, 15 through 68, you will understand that we are the children of this book, and this book belongs to us, and it's for us. All right? The Quran is not. But nonetheless, I want to read verse 15 and 15 through 17, and then maybe one or two others, just so you can get that. But then I can get to the plan. This is Deuteronomy 28 and 15. This is Moses speaking to the Israelites. It says, "But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee." So if we didn't obey God, there would be curses to come upon us. All right? Because if you read verses 1 through 14, it tells us if we do listen, the blessings will come upon us. We're going to get those later, because we went and disobeyed him. All right? So now we're under the curses. It says, "Cursed shalt thou be in the city, and cursed shalt thou be in the field. Cursed shall be thy basket and thy store." Okay, so we were cursed during slavery, and we're even cursed now, to where you can't walk, you can't jog down the street, you can't chill in your house, you can't get a speeding ticket. All those things can end in death. All right, so we're cursed in the city as well. It says, "Cursed shall be thy basket and thy store." So even when our people get businesses, they aren't high-level businesses. If they are high-level businesses, they've sold out. They've taken the bag. They've sold their soul. They've done things that they shouldn't have done. They've broken the law of the Heavenly Father. All right? See that? He says you have rejected his law. Okay? And his law, you simply by looking at you, you know, we don't judge men based on your appearance, but by looking at just this picture alone, you're breaking laws of the Heavenly Father. If you can grow a beard, you shouldn't be shaving it. Okay? You shouldn't be getting lineups. All right? You that part that you have in your hair, and most likely it's not a natural part, that was probably done by clippers. You're not supposed to make baldness on your head, man. Okay? So all of these things are breaking the law of the Heavenly Father. You know, even wearing that bow tie is technically not breaking the law, but that's a phallic symbol. Okay? They used to call those dicky ties or dicky bows, because they say it looks like a dick on your neck, man. When you go into regular men, when you go into men's ties, those are all phallic symbols. Phallic symbols mean they represent a phallus or a penis, all right? Penis and balls, man. And they have those in symbols of like Egyptology and things like that to represent fertility, and sexuality and woman worship, a lot of those things too, man. You know, like I said, but this is not to get on your appearance either. I don't want to get off topic, but I just have to bring those up, okay? Because doing breaking those laws alone, and if you hear about it, you are now turning your ear to the law of the Lord. And that's when the Lord decide, will destroy men. He said, he that turneth, when you read Proverbs 28:9, it says, he that turneth his ear away from hearing the law, even his prayer shall be an abomination, man. A defiled and detestable thing. But, you know, so those things that were happening to us in the books of Deuteronomy, the curses, those things are still upon us, all right? And that's the things that people don't understand. The Lord said he was going to destroy us for the things that we did unto him, all right? This is Deuteronomy 28 and verse 33. It says, the fruit of thy land and all thy labors shall a nation which thou knowest not eat up, and thou shalt be only oppressed and crushed always, man. Okay, so a nation which we know is not are these modern day Americans, which are known as Edomites, according to the Bible. All right, so all our labors, they eat up. Just like when we tried to have a plan when we did Tulsa, Oklahoma, Black Wall Street. What did they do? They brought planes and burned it to the ground, man. So you're saying all this about a plan, but the plan is only in the waiting of our Messiah, of our Lord. This cannot be done by man alone. We need divine, heavenly, and spiritual intervention in order to truly make that change, man. And that's what your modern everyday man is impatient to do. 2 Peter 3:3 says that the scoffers, in the last day there should be scoffers, and they shall say, where is the promise of his coming? See, that's the thing. Majority of our people don't want to wait on the Lord. They want to know how they can make a kingdom here. We don't want this kingdom. This is why he said, you're an Israelite, you got to wake up to that. Meaning, we don't want this kingdom. The true elect of the nation of Israel, we know that this kingdom that is ruled by the so-called white man has to be destroyed in order to make ours, man. All right, say for instance, there is a plot of land and it has a old, corrupt, defiled building on it, right? You're not going to say, you know, there are some people that say, hey, let's go in and fix this up. But if you really want to start something new, if you want to have a true plan, you have to destroy that building and now create something new, man. All right? But you're trying to build up something that Edomites are inhabiting. Inside that house, there are Edomites living in there, just torturing our people. All right? And so the only way to fix this is through the Lord, man. That's the only way to do this. Okay? So let me jump down and see if I can. This is verse 63. It says, and it shall come to pass that as the Lord rejoiced over you to do you good and to multiply you, so the Lord will rejoice over you to destroy you and to bring you to naught, and ye shall be plucked off the land whither thou goest to possess it. So, hey, just as the Lord will bring us up and give us so much joy, he will rejoice in destroying us, man. And that's what's happening with 2/3 of our people still to this day. All right, jumping down to verse 65, and among these nations thou shalt find no ease. Matter of fact, I might as well read 64 for you so you can understand that cobblestone. All right, and the Lord shall scatter thee among all the people from the one end of the earth even unto the other, and there thou shalt serve other gods which neither thou nor thy fathers have known, even wood and stone. That's why you have our people celebrating the modern day Christianity. All right. When the Israelites are the real Christians. That's why you have people like yourself serving the Kaaba stone. All right. Who are off in the Islam. Okay. That's the stone. Those are the two main predominant religions that our people are confused in, where religion means to divide and restrain. The Bible is not a religious book, man. You know, he started to mention, what did he call it? He said, you all have a sense of intellectual masturbation, meaning that men are stroking their egos, so to speak. And that's the thing. We hear a great millstone. We're not here to stroke our egos. You know, the Lord says, humble thyself in the sight of the Lord, and the Lord shall lift you up and exalt you, man. So we're not here to stroke our egos. We're here to find the hopeful elect of the Lord. All right. Build them up so that our Lord may come back and redeem us from this situation, so that we can be delivered from this hell, man. Because the Messiah is coming to deliver those who have faith and those who believe. All right? This says, and among these nations shalt thou find no ease, and neither shall the sole of thy foot have rest, but the Lord shall give thee there a trembling heart and failing of eyes and a sorrow of mind. And thy life shall hang in doubt before thee, and thou shalt fear day and night and shall have no assurance of thy life, man. So that's what our people are still suffering through. We don't have any ease among these nations. We can't build the kingdom that you want to see here in America. America is going to be destroyed by 200 million missiles. So why would we want to have a plan for this place? Okay? Why would we want to have a plan for this place? Of course, we live here, so we have to be wise. Like, you have to go out and get a job, make money, do what you have to do. We're not saying just give up your life and don't do anything until the Lord comes back. But your mind needs to be focused on the Bible, the Spirit, the will of the Heavenly Father. The scriptures say, fear the Most High and keep His commandments. This is the whole conclusion. This is the whole duty of man. That's the conclusion of the matter, man. So that's what we need to be doing. That should be our first thing, all right? You know, like Elder Ariella said, keep the main thing, man. Okay? Now, let me get... this is the main part of our plan that most men won't receive. Okay? This is Zephaniah 3 and 8. It says... therefore, wait ye upon me, saith the Lord, Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shai, until the day that I rise up to the prey. So the Lord said we have to wait for him to rise up to the prey. Because right now, we're the prey. And our enemies, the Edomites, are the predators. But the Lord says in Jeremiah that he's going to turn, Jeremiah the 16th chapter, that he's going to turn his fishers into hunters. So our enemies, these other nations, are going to be the prey. That's our plan, man. It's the way for the Lord, because we're going to be given new bodies. Our plan, see, our plan is composed of, it has all the elements, all right? It has the introduction, it has the layout, it has the blueprint, okay? It has how we're going to do it. It has the new bodies that we're going to be given to do it in. It has the level of, it lets us know about the other nations destroying America. So this Bible is a full plan of what's going to happen on earth. So why go into try to find and create your own plan when the Lord, he said he found it, he created the beginning, the end from the beginning, according to Isaiah 46 and 10. Why try to create your own plan when the Lord, we're talking about the creator, the Almighty. He already created a plan. Why not follow his plan? Because guess what? His plan is sealed in stone. It's etched in stone. It's going to happen. He said, I shall do all my pleasure and my counsel shall stand, man. Okay. But going on in that verse, it says, for my determination is to gather the nations, that I may assemble the kingdoms, to pour upon them mine indignation, even all my fierce anger. For all the earth shall be devoured with the fire of my jealousy. You see that? So the Lord said he's going to completely destroy these nations, man. All right? He's going to use the elect of Israel to do it. That's our plan, man. So this is why you need to understand it's bigger than, oh, let's come together regardless of our religions. I just got a couple scriptures came to mind right now, you know. But that's why we can't just come together and think, oh, it's going to happen that way. This is another reason. Amos 3 and 3. It says, can two walk together except they be agreed? So we can't walk with Muslims because they don't agree with what we agree with. We don't believe in our people being Muslims. We don't agree with our people worshiping false gods. We don't believe in carnality. We don't believe in making a plan that's going to help us salvage ourselves and our people in America. Majority of our people are wicked. Majority of our people are wicked. And that's what you don't understand. So you walk around, people walk around and think that every, oh, he's a black man, he's cool, he's good. 66% of our people are wicked, man. Thus saith the Lord. Okay? So we can't agree with everybody. All right? I just got some more. And these all go together. These are all precepts that I'm about to bring out that laps right on each other, you know? This is 1 Corinthians 1 and 10, it says, now I beseech you, brethren, by the name of our Lord, Yahweh Shai Mashiach, that ye speak all this, that ye all speak the same thing. See that? So we got to speak the same thing to make a plan. So you're saying put religion aside, but you can do that with some of these other camps. But the Lord says he's coming to commend those who stood stiffly for his name and for his doctrine. Okay, so we're not just buddying up with everybody. Yeah, the scriptures say, oh ye nation not desire, gather yourselves together. Okay, but that's talking about the elect of those nations who believe. That's not just everybody just because, oh, they say I'm an Israelite. Oh, just because you got brown skin, all right, means we need to click up. No, man, you got to understand the mind of the Heavenly Father to the best of your ability. All right, it says that ye all speak the same thing, that there be no divisions among you. But ye, it said no division. So that's a division. If you believe Allah is God, that's a division between us. No, we can't build. All right, we can't build that way. All right, you got to understand that, because that's not building. That's anti-building. I'm putting a brick on and you're taking the brick back off. Okay, because you're leading our people, telling them, like, oh yeah, we're doing this in the name of Allah. Allah put this together. That won't work, man. Which, that is not even a name. Okay, we doing this in the name of Yahweh Ba'asham Yahushua, the one true power, man. It says, that ye may be, and look, I understand I don't speak as soft-toned as a lot of men. So, hey, man, but the scriptures say, woe unto those the offenses shall come. So if you're offended by my tone and you're offended, and I'm trying my best not to use expletives because I can use those rather often. All right. I tend to enjoy them, actually, because they make Jake realize that we not here for no. I'm gonna just say it plain. No bullshit. All right. We not, you know, the Lord ain't about little semantics about what your choice of words. All right. He's not that small, man. Y'all keep putting the Most High in the box. They just words. If you believe in his word, he don't care. Though I be rude in speech, yet not in knowledge, man. And they even say in the world, if a man uses expletives, he's more than likely telling the truth. Okay. But nonetheless, for the sake of this argument, this discussion, you know, I'm trying not to use them because I know y'all people get bent out of shape when a man use too many so-called curse words. All right. New speech. It says, but that ye be perfectly joined together in the same mind and in the same judgment. See, that's the thing. We're not on the same mind, and we're not in the same. You're not thinking of the same judgment as we are, man. You thinking that if we build here in America, everything's going to be OK. But we don't feel that way, man. OK, we do not feel that way. We know that our Messiah is coming to destroy this place, and anything that you build, the Messiah is going to destroy. OK. Let me get, what is that, Romans? You know, and I don't want to make this too long, you know. But nonetheless, the scripture's got to come out. This is Romans 16 and 17. Now I beseech you, brethren, mark them which cause divisions and offenses. It says mark them, skopeo in the Greek. You know, like Gabar Yahweh to be saying, hey, skope his ass, man. All right. Now I beseech you, brethren, mark them which cause divisions and offenses contrary to the doctrine which ye have learned, and avoid them. So this is why we avoid each other. And this is speaking about other Israelites, too. If you got another Israelite camp and they're out camp just trying to look all pretty and organized, that's a division. You got a camp, they're saying the name of the Lord is Jesus Christ, that's a division. If you got another group and they getting lineups and wearing dreads, that's a division. If you got another group saying the mark of the beast is not the RFID chip, that's a division. And so we mark them and we avoid them because we know that's not according to the will of the Heavenly Father, man. Okay? It says, for they that are such serve not our Lord, Yahweh Shai Mashiach, but their own belly. All right? So we're not, so like you said, those intellectual masturbators, they're serving their own belly. We're not those men. Okay, we are men that are standing uprightly and boldly for the name of the Lord. It says, and by good words and fair speeches deceive the hearts of the simple. You see that? So by good orators and your nice suits and sounding good, all right, and using the perfect words, that's how you deceive the simple. Proverbs the first chapter said, oh ye simple ones, how long shall you love simplicity? All right. The elect of Israel, Lord willing, we're of that number. We aren't simple, man. And we're seeing past all of the BS. Okay? And we're actually searching for the Lord. So we're waiting on our Lord to come back. And I you know, in the world, what they say, you know, they try to talk, because the scriptures say, wait upon the Lord, or those that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They try to switch that to make it worldly. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, if you wait, those that are wait won't ever get what they want, or something like that. You know, that nonsense, man. All right. But this is what the Lord asks us to do. He says, this is Jeremiah 6 and 16, it says, thus saith the Lord, stand ye in the ways and see, and ask for the old paths, where is the good way, and walk therein, and ye shall find rest for your souls. But they said, we will not walk therein. So that's what y'all do. Y'all don't say we won't. Y'all find out, y'all Israelites, y'all find out about the truth. But y'all don't look for the old way. Y'all don't look for the ancient paths. Y'all don't. Hey, what they say, you got to know where you're coming from to know where you're going. So you have to know you're an Israelite and believe that and search the paths of old in order to find what's going to come to you in the future. All right. And what's going to come to men that don't repent is going to be absolute and utter destruction through the spirit of the Lord, man. Okay. He's going to slay you in worse ways than you can ever think, man. And your minister, Farrakhan, he's out literally conning people, man. He knows he's an Israelite. He knows the truth. All right? But he still shaves his beard off and shit, still tries to sound nice and pretty with those fair speeches. Okay? And I know you reverence the man, so I'm not saying this out of a sign of disrespect. I'm saying this out of a sign of truth and fact of what he does, man, and how he doesn't follow after the Lord. And how he rather serves idol gods, because that idol god can profit him. It can fill his belly. It can put money in his pockets. It can make him esteemed and famous in this society. But we're not looking for that. But the Lord said he's going to give us that anyway. All right? If you seek throne and scepters, seek wisdom. He also said, he's going to give us the desire of our hearts. And he said he's going to give us praise and fame anyway, man. But y'all want it now, and that's not the solution, okay? It says, verse 17, also I set watchmen over you. See that? The Lord set watchmen over you, which are the elect of the nation of Israel, the men that are doing his work, saying, hearken to the sound of the trumpet. But they said, we will not hearken, all right? And that's what our people do. They don't, hearken means to listen. Our people will not hearken, man, okay? And verse 19 says, hear, O earth, behold, I will bring evil upon this people, even the fruit of their thoughts, because they have not hearkened unto my words, nor to my law, but rejected it. You know? So you rejected the law and the words of the Heavenly Father. So he said he's going to bring evil upon you. All right? Even the fruit of your thoughts. So your worst thoughts, the Lord will still bring that judgment to you, because martial law is about to break out in America. And you're talking about building a plan. All right? That's like that's that Edomite mentality, man. Let's make a plan for how crazy things can get. Let's get some financial wealth. You can't get none of that, man. If the Lord wanted us to be rich right now and balling out of control and living a good life, he would have done it, man. The Heavenly Father says it is a light thing to make a man rich. Okay? It's a light thing. It's simple for him to do that. Okay? But this ain't the time for this. It says it's better to be in the house of mourning than in the house of feasting, man. And that's what you're trying to do. You're trying to be in the house of feasting. Okay? You're trying to rejoice when it's the time to repent. All right? We just looked up repent the other day, which is nacham in the Hebrew, which means to be sorrowful and to be regretful, you know? But you're not in that spirit. You're telling people that it's all right, come to the nation of Islam. All right, let's build, let's make a plan. But our plan is reading this Bible, repenting, and coming back to the Lord and Savior, who is going to deliver us from this hell, man. And on Judgment Day, when the Messiah cracks those claws in his chariots and he beams up his elect, you don't want to be the man in Wisdom and 5th chapter crying and groaning and repenting the spirit, man, because you decided not to repent until it was too late. Okay? And this is verse 21. I'm trying to think of another verse that I had off the top of my head, but I'll read this verse. Jeremiah 6 and 21. Therefore, thus saith the Lord, behold, I will lay stumbling blocks before this people, and fathers and the sons together shall fall upon them. The neighbor and his friend shall perish. You see that? So the Lord lays stumbling blocks upon you. That's why you can't see, why can't we create a plan? All right? That's why you can't see, even though you know you're an Israelite, why you don't want to cleave all the way on. Because the lifestyle that you're leading now, you're getting fame, you're getting subscribers, you're getting people that like you, get some women that's coming around, you know, you're getting nice clothes. Hey, man, it says in the scriptures, what is the profit of man to gain the whole world and lose his soul? Hey, Brother Ben X, man, if you so happen to hear this message, don't give up your soul for this, man. It's not worth it, all right? It won't be worth it. And to come back as a two-third in the kingdom, although all of our people are going to be in the kingdom afterwards and happy, But two-thirds of our people going to have a shame and everlasting contempt, man. All right? And they're going to be walking around with their heads down saying, I wish I'd have listened. I wish I would have hearkened. Okay? Because they're going to see the glory that the Lord is going to bestow upon the elect. Okay? And I had a scripture in my mind, and it just fled me. You know, let me get Hebrews, though. Why that's on me. Hebrews 13 and 14. For here have we no continuing city, but we seek one to come. All right? So we don't have a continuing city, so we can't create and build here in Babylon. All right? But we seek one to come. We seek what the Heavenly Father has promised to his elect, man, which are great things. You know? When you read, what's that? Psalms 126, it says, we going to be like those that dream, and we're going to say he have done great things for us, man. All right? But it's not going to be Allah. It's going to be Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai, man. All right? That's it. It says, this is Psalms 126 and 1. When the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, which is us, Zion in Hebrew is to Zion, which means my monument. We are the monument of the Lord. It says, we were like them that dream. Then was our mouth filled with laughter and our tongue with singing. Then said they among the heathen, the Lord hath done great things for them. All right, so the Lord is going. That's what the heathen are going to be saying. Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah have done great things for them, and we're going to be singing, man. All right, it says the Lord hath done great things for us, whereof we are glad. Turn again our captivity, O Lord, as the streams in the south, that they that sow in tears shall reap in joy, man. So the elect of Israel are sowing in tears right now. All right, so we're going to reap in joy, man. All right. We cry now and we're going to laugh later. But y'all people are laughing now and y'all going to cry later, man. It's some bad things happening to our people. And you know you're an Israelite. So the Lord says, you're going to have blood on your hands, man. All right? And he said, if you got blood on hands, he going to require that at thy life. He going to require that at thy hand, man. All right? So it's time you get this together. And I got one more precept that I did another clip on earlier. So I'm going to just add that to the end of this, you know. And I'll just put that piece on there. But Lord willing, this lesson was edifying, man. I want to give all the praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai Bahashem, Rakha Kodash. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone. And peace and mercy to the house of David, the elect, the men that are doing this work in sincerity and truth. Hey, brothers, come back and repent. Sisters, come back and repent. Hey, our Lord is on his way. And you can see that by the current state of the world, man. All right? We waiting for that mark of the beast to come out. And the dollar is going to collapse. America is going to fall. Thus saith the Lord, and thus saith the Bible. All right? So, hey, Lord, when this lesson was edifying, hey, Brother Ben X, you better repent or the Lord going to take you out, man. So with that, until next time, Shalom. 2 Ezra 7 and 56. For while we lived and committed iniquity, we considered not that we should begin to suffer for it after death. Okay? So when you're thinking of these men saying things like this, okay, you don't realize that you're talking about the condition that we're in. The condition that we are in is due to our disobedience, okay? And so it's just like having a parent, right? In order to get back in the good graces of your parent, you have to do what is right, okay? You have to fix your mindset. You can't keep corrupting. You have to uncorrupt your thought process, man. And so what's happened with our people, with so-called blacks, Native Americans and Hispanics, is that they continuously think that we aren't suffering for the things that happened unto us in our past lives. All right. The disrespect that we show towards the Heavenly Father. And so that's why you people, and by you people, I'm not talking about Muslims. I'm talking about Israelites, you so-called blacks, Native Americans, and Hispanics. The reason you think the way that you do is because you think that you can fix your own situation. You think that you can get yourself out of the situation that we are in. And that is simply the furthest thing from the truth. We need a savior, okay? And y'all go and y'all preach Allah, 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 right? Which simply means power, okay? But you never speak of a savior coming to redeem you from your situation, because men like you, Brother Ben X, you think that you can come up with a plan for our whole nation. And look what happened with our predecessors. Look who a big ambassador for the nation of Islam, which is Malcolm X. All right.
Look at all of what he achieved, and he still could not unite our people. It's because he was not ordained to be a prophet unto the nations. He was not ordained to save the nation of Israel. He was not ordained to speak the 100% unadulterated truth. And just like how he could not come up with the plan to save our people, you will not either, because we need the Heavenly Father and his Son, Yahweh, Yahweh Shai. Point blank, period. Okay? It says, then answered he me and said, this is the condition of the battle, which man that is born upon the earth shall fight. So that's why we're suffering. Okay? This is the condition of the battle. When you take, when you talk to somebody in the army, okay, and they talk about having weapons and tactical gear and getting shot at and bombs, things blown, that's a condition of the battle. So one part of our condition of the battle is that we suffered this in our reincarnation, and that we're suffering for the things that we did in aforetime right now. Okay? It says that if he be overcome, he shall suffer as thou hast said, but if he get the victory, he shall receive the thing that I say. So, right, we're not going to, the victory that you're talking about is a carnal, worldly victory where the so-called white man is still in rulership, okay? The scriptures talk about breaking down those strongholds by the words of the Heavenly Father, okay? So we have to keep prophesying until our Lord and Savior, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ, returns. And that's our plan, okay? That is our plan. And that's why the young man said, you have to understand that you're an Israelite, and that's why you can't get past the fact that what does that have to do with what we're doing? Okay, so I just wanted to get those scriptures because I didn't have my apocrypha with me, but I'm going to switch.